We've never lived at a time when information comes quite as fast as it does. And one of the things it's important to help young people with is how to sort it into what's useful and what's not useful. The problem I think a lot of educators face today isn't so much the speed of information, it's holding the attention of young people. I heard an educator give a speech a couple of years ago in which he talked about how his students always came to class in the morning all bleary-eyed. They said, I've been up all night doing my homework, but they didn't seem to know anything. And upon further investigation, he discovered what they meant is that their laptop was open for 6 hours last night, but the amount of it they actually spent on the schoolwork was very small compared to the time they were spending on Facebook and watching videos on YouTube and doing a variety of other things. The point is that we have to somehow find ways to help young people learn to budget their time, to be sensible about their time. There's a study at Rutgers a few years ago in which a professor had a group of 82 students to go without their cell phones for 2 days to see what the effects would be. Only 1/4 of the students could finish the study. 3/4 of the students could not go without their cell phones for 2 days. They dropped out of the study in less than 2 days. This is what one is battling with. The problem isn't the speed at which information flows. The problem is getting young people to budget their time, and in particular, to leave time for reflection and also for rest.